This week's Ask Dr. Durie comes from a patient who has heard that MRD testing for myeloma had recently been approved by the FDA. This patient is correct in that on April the 12th, there was a meeting by ODAC, the Oncology Drug Advisory Committee, a branch of the FDA, a committee called together by the FDA, did have a 12-0 approval vote for the use of MRD testing, minimal residual disease testing, as an early endpoint for the accelerated approval of drugs in trials, both in the frontline setting and at relapse. And so this was a major vote in support of the use of MRD testing. To achieve this, the I2 team, the independent international team for endpoint approval of MRD in multiple myeloma, a team brought together under the International Myeloma Working Group, IMWG, and linked to the Black Swan Research Initiative, this team pulled together data from around 20 trials and the data from over 12,000 individual patients in whom MRD testing had been conducting. And the team pulled together all of this information and presented it to the FDA. The information showed that there was enough in the frontline transplant eligible as well as transplant ineligible and the relapse refractory setting, enough to indicate that MRD testing can be used as a acceptable indicator for accelerated approval. One of the questions was, at what time should the testing be performed? Data were presented for both 12 months and 9 months from the start of a particular line of therapy, and data were strong for both of those time points. And so the bottom line is that based upon the 12-0 vote by the ODAC committee, MRD is now considered an acceptable endpoint, an early endpoint for the accelerated approval of a new therapy or a new combination. And what this means across the board is that this early decision at 9 or 12 months is substantially earlier than the longer follow-up normally required for progression-free survival, the length of the remission, which with modern therapies, with current immune therapies, for example, can be over 5 years. So there is a tremendous advantage and the achievement of much more timely approval, which is an advantage for patients, an advantage for the pharma drug development teams, and for the myeloma community as a whole.